Today we are going to start the fifth chapter of our honeycomb book, and the name of the chapter is Quality. Quality, this chapter is written by John Galsworthy, which describes the beautiful artist who is a shoemaker. This chapter is about Mr. Jessler, who is a German, who was basically a German and who had settled in London with his elder brother, and they own a shoe shop, where they make their own shoes and sell them in the busy streets of London. This chapter is about how beautifully, how passionately he used to make shoes. He used to add beauty and quality to his boots, and how the competitive market and the big companies, shoemaking companies, took his job away and let him die out of starvation. So children, let's start the chapter. Along with this, I have written the new words. You have to look at these new words carefully and write these down in your fair notebook. Let's start the chapter. The author, John Galsworthy, says he knew the shoemaker, Mr. Jessler, he knew him from the days of his father, when his father used to go to Mr. Jessler for making his boots. And slowly, when he became an adult, he also started going to the Jessler shop for making his own boots. He says his shop was in the, he said his shop was in the busy streets of London by a small by street. By street means gully, a small street, a narrow street, and his shop had a distinction. His shop had a quality and special feature that his shop has only a few shoes which were displayed from the glass window, glass panel, and there was no signboard over his shop. So there was no signboard over the boot shop of Mr. Jessler, and he made boots in a very good way, which were long lasting, which were good in quality, and which were very much cheaper or comparatively cheaper than the other stores or other shoe shops. Now he says he always, Mr. Jessler, whenever they went to Mr. Jessler's shop, he used to gaze or stare at his boots just to see, yes, his art or his artistic work is, or his creation is a piece of artistic work. And he always used to say that it is an art. Making shoes is an art. Now, it was not possible to go to him or go to Mr. Jessler every time or very often, because once we buy shoes, it lasts for 2 or 3 years. So there were sometimes he used to go once in 2 years or 3 years, he used to go to Mr. Jessler for purchasing shoes. Now by this time the author was an adult, and he went to his shop. He ordered him, he told him to show him some shoes. Mr. Jessler was wearing an apron, and he went inside into the godown to get some shoes. And till then, he was author was sitting on a stool and gazing or looking at the other shoes which were displayed, which were being displayed at the shop. Now he asked Mr. Jessler, how are you, and do you have any boots in Russian leather? Now without giving a second, Mr. Jessler said, yes, we have. And he went inside to take those boots back, or take the Russian leather boots from the manufacturing, means from the inside of, from the corner of his shop. Now when he came back, he showed it to him, and he said, this is a very beautiful piece, and you must try it on. Now he asked him, do you want them, or when do you want these shoes to be ready? He said, the author said I want these shoes within 15 days, so please prepare or make fulfill my order within 15 days. Then he said, okay, I will ask my brother and I will tell you. Then the means every time the author went to his shop, he purchased a lot of, or he bought a lot of shoes from him, and he always tried to purchase something from his shops because he knew that his condition, his restless condition, was not very good, and he is working hard to get some money so that he could run his family, to so that he could get something to eat. Okay, now once the author went to him and he complained that last time whatever shoes I brought from your shop, I bought from your shop, is creaked. Creaked means it made a creaking sound. Now this was for the first time the author was having a complaint regarding the shoes he purchased from Mr. Jessler. So Jessler was a bit confused and he was shocked. How can my shoes, or the shoes I have made, creak? Then he said, he was very hopeless on hearing this, and he said, okay, if it should not creak, but if it is creaking, you can bring it back, I will see it. Then when the author one again came to his shop to show him his shoes was creaking, then the Mr. Jessler looked at it carefully and he said, these are not his own boots. These boots don't belong to him, and these are not made by him. He said, these shoes belong to a big shopkeepers or big manufacturing company, shoe company. And he started feeling very bad. He was very dissatisfied when he realized that those were not his boots. He was not feeling very angry, nor he was very sad, but somewhere he was dissatisfied that these big firms, these big companies, boot companies, they sell cheap products to the buyers, customers, and they take the work from these small people like Mr. Jessler, people like him. Because many people, they go to big shops for buying fancy things which is of very poor quality. And he said, these all, the big firms, the big companies, they earn all this, or they attract all the customers by putting good advertisements, and they take away our profession, they take away our work, they don't let any people to come in our shop. So he said, they get it by advertisement, not by work. Means they don't make good quality shoes, they just put on good advertisements on TV and on articles and newspapers, and they get the job of our own, and they just give their customers bad quality or cheap quality shoes, and they keep us starved. They take away our bread, they take away our chances or our opportunities for earning money. So class, up to this we are doing today. What you have to do at home is, you have to watch the video carefully, write down these new words in your fair note. Okay, write these new words in your fair note. I'll see you tomorrow. That's it for today. Thank you.